Strong Beach, Doc Dossman. We headed to the beach. Let's go. Okay, Strong Beach, today we're talking about shin splints. Not so much the definition of them or where they come from, but we're going to talk about solutions. Anybody like solutions? Ha-ha! Now, everyone seems to be able to diagnose you, your coach, your trainer, your doctor, your uncle that ran a half marathon in the 1960s, and they all have solutions for you, I think. Basically, if you run and you have pain either here or here, anywhere along here or here, you got shin splints. So many levels of pain. Let's just say the more it hurts, the farther along in your condition you are. It's a good rule of thumb, right? Now, if it's just starting to hurt, it's just very likely that it's gonna progress and get worse. But make no mistake about it, you've got shin splints right now. Why not do something about it right now? The typical shin splint treatments are ice, rest, and over-the-counter anti-inflammatories. Now, this stuff actually helps, but unfortunately, it's only Band-Aid. The issue is that the problem will be sure to return when you go back to running. How can we treat to heal and strengthen for prevention? How can we make you stronger to get back to that surface that beat you up in the first place? Now, when the foot is flat, it causes the inner shin muscles to overstretch. This causes weakness and micro tearing, which leads to inflammation. Bam! You got shin splints. Since the foot is a major factor with shin splints, it's easy to say that you're going to need a good pair of shoes and proper foot orthotics to start your road to recovery. I like postural corrective heel cups. They're not exactly custom orthotics, but they're definitely a thrifty alternative. Anything that you place inside of your sneaker to support your arch or correct some form of posture in your foot is considered an orthotic. It doesn't have to be an arch support. If the muscle is regularly subjected to an even greater dynamic and eccentric contraction than during the intended exercise, it will become more capable of handling the ordinary amount of stress. With that said, the strengthening of your shin muscles are top priority when it comes to rehabilitation and prevention of shin splints. So one of our first options for tibialis anterior strengthening, or shin strengthening, is downhill running. Slow, controlled downhill running strengthens the shin muscle. Another alternative is heel walking. That's it. You walk on your heels. Keep walking on your heels. Next alternative, toe tapping. Keep tapping, keep tapping. You'll feel the burn come. Your calves are what we call the antagonist muscle to your shins, so stretching them is very crucial. When the calf muscle is tight, the shin muscle has to work that much harder in the opposite direction, sort of like a tug of war. So we like to loosen up this area by stretching the calf muscle, which will free up the range of motion in the shin and the ankle. We can tape the arch to give more support, and then we can tape the shin muscle to encourage a faster healing time. Cold laser therapy is a form of medical treatment which involves the use of a low-intensity laser to address pain and inflammation. This treatment is generally classified as experimental or investigational. But that's crazy. I've been using cold laser therapy since 2003 and get amazing results. Active release technique, ice, and rest. Very important components to your recovery. But you know what? Rest is oftentimes mistaken for rest. But rest doesn't necessarily have to mean a complete stop to all activity. We can still do things to maintain your conditioning. You can run on a softer surface like the grass, maybe even the sand. You can do pool water workouts, good for your joints. The elliptical is pretty good, and the stationary bicycle, of course. All right, so that's it for shin splints. There's an answer, there is a solution, you can get help, and there's more to it than ice and rest, all right? So until next week, we're gonna start a new series on stretching, dynamic versus static. Which do you do when? We're gonna talk about all that good stuff on next week, okay? So y'all stay tuned. Until then, stay strong, Beach.